Jehovah-Jireh-Yahnu. You're the God of awesome wonders. I've tasted of your power.
And the person died, for, you know, 1 or 2 weeks ago. You are eating so much food in the gym, all kinds of delicacies, but you are alive. Everybody was not to rise all the time. We are standing on holy ground. I know that there are angels all around. That's all. one time.
Be my God.
They ask for the man.
I'm We are not celebrating that subject. We are not praying that what is our solution center.
we give Lord the glory. We thank you, Almighty God. So it's a day worth celebrating. And I want to thank you all for playing with us. I want to appreciate you for your love, those who are constantly the key into our programs. And I raise my request as a prophet of the living God, that the blessing of God shall flow into life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray, King of kings and Lord of all, that King will give accelerated purpose to Jesus' King.
Amen.
I receive accelerated blessings.
Amen.
Receive accelerated breakthrough.
Amen.
Join us, know the situation all over the world. And as I said, you can also link us to the YouTube. And by the time we finalize everything concerning your permanent YouTube channel, we'll let you know. But from time to time before the service, I'll be sending it out. When we started Zoom also too, it was from time to time that we were changing it until we did certain things with Zoom people so that Lord gave us a permanent solution. So we are also working towards Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 51, verse 20, the Bible says, I may do a battle axe and a weapon of war, that you shall break in pieces the nations, that you shall break in pieces the kingdoms. Not only that, we are going to break in pieces man and woman. We are going to break in pieces the man and the male. We are going to break in pieces the shadows and the riders. We are going to break in pieces what? The horse and what? The rider. With that spirit, I want to pray. We are supposed to be a battle axe. Not only that, if you go to Jeremiah chapter number 12, verse number 6, he said, if you run with the footman and you are with, what will you do with the horse? So my horse, you are a war horse. Say, I am a war horse.
I'm a war horse.
With the spirit of the war horse, you are going to pray. Say, my star, shine to fall no more.
Shine to fall no more.
Jesus, we ask you, shine to fall no more. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Think about that one. Every power question in my brain room. Hello. Question Moses, say, who is that God? Who is that God? If you look at the book of Exodus, chapter 5, the last verse, then chapter 6, the first verse, say, every power questioning my breakthroughs. Yeah! In Jesus' name, say, every plan for my finances. Satanic plans for my business. Satanic plan for my career. Satanic plan for my ministry. Satanic plans for my marriage. Cash fire in the name of Jesus. As you are going into your world, come and teach us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All these people want to see you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Now, I've already sent out the topic of this lesson. How to prophesy, cast out demons, and walk miracles, and still go to hellfire. It's a very long topic. How to prophesy, cast out demons, walk miracles, and still go to hellfire. Yes, thank you for the Lord. If we look at what is happening over the world, these are obvious signs. These are conspicuous signs. These are visible signs that the prophecies of the Lord Jesus Christ, they are coming. I said, nation shall rise against nation. Okay? In our own generation, we have seen nations that are rising up against nation. The world is tough. Countries oppress one another. In recent years, you see what is happening in Venezuela. An American government seems to be supporting the Speaker of the House so as to take over from Maduro, the president. This is nation oppressing nation. Praise the name of the Lord. So, this it is not when they go into physical combat that nation arrested nation warfare, this nation. There are ideological warfare going on. Or ideological warfare because it belongs to this ideology, I cannot do something with it. There are a form of warfare going on. Many years ago, I stumbled on a book called The Open Place of Latin America. The Open Place of Latin America was just a chronicle of how European countries and other nations came to Latin America and then they oppressed them. And then you know, took away their knowledge. And similar things, if you read about Africa, how water road, how you know, Europe underdeveloped Africa. You can see all kinds of national nations oppressing nations. It's a signpost that anything that happens, the sisters talk to the regular. Somebody signed key and some of people are talking about. They said people should get ready because people don't know what will happen. When the issue of 5G technology and this relationship with coronavirus started, people came also asking the question as a pastor because a lot of pastors also dabbled into what I call you know, incongruous eschatology. Eschatology that does not fit into what the Bible is saying. Praise the name of the Lord. Eschatology is the story of end time. And when they called me, I said, give me time. They even showed some of the clips of lecture people are talking about so and so forth. I didn't respond because I'm a chartered accountant. I didn't know anything about all the things we're talking about. I called people. Within 2 days, they supplied me, they sent me 3 submissions from 3 professors of radiation physics from the University of Ibadan. I read through those submissions. Then they also sent me some submissions about some countries where they're already developing 7GHG. Okay, I read through. Then I now call those people that have been asking me questions and so on. Okay, well, as far as I'm concerned, there is no correlation. There is no variation. I mean, there is no relationship between 5G and coronavirus. In fact, the write-up of those 3 professors of radiation physics from the University of Ibadan, they called, they said, these people that don't dabble their little, dabble to what they don't know. I am a pastor, so I don't dabble to what I don't know. But then, when all these things are happening, we have to be very careful. How to prophesy, cast out demons, and at the same time, go to hellfire. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you look at what it says, you pack your shoes after you discover that some of the shoes there, they are even becoming tight when you put it on. They are dabbling dust, the breakfast are putting on there. Things have happened so much in our environment that people are not conscious. I look at the book of Matthew chapter 7. Everybody go to that place. Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7. I start from verse 21. Not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. And you see, but he that dwelleth in the will of my Father, which is in heaven. No wonder the Bible says, it's not the hearers of the word that be justified, but what? The doers of the word. See, not everyone that said, Lord, Lord, Lord. You have come upon the Lord today, and heaven is your goal. The essence of redeeming people, when God redeems you, so bring us into close relationship with him. He said, not everyone that said, Lord, Lord, not everybody shall go into heaven. Many will say to me that day, Lord, Lord, I do not prophesy in their name. To me, the people that prophesy, they are mostly all these Pentecostal churches and Alabama churches. If you look at other churches, the Ale, you know, what do you call it, the Ale Buddhism. This statement gives us a lot of body. It gives us a lot of worry concerning what is going on all over the place. You say, many will say to me that day, Lord, Lord, I do not prophesy in their name. In their name, I cast out devils. And in their name, not many wonderful words. Can you see? And then we had professor unto them, I never knew the path of me that walked in iniquity. God is talking, he said, it is possible for you to prophesy. It is possible for you to cast out demons. It is possible for you to walk many miracles, and you are not in the will of God. He said, I never knew you. You are workers of iniquity. This is a matter of concern. It's a matter of mental thoughts. It's a matter to ruminate upon. It's a matter to really meditate upon. If you are in the ministry, brothers and sisters, there is no pastor, there is no minister that can tell you he knows how miracles happen. Miracles, healing, deliverance are the works of the Holy Spirit. I've been in the ministry for years. I don't know how it happened. I don't know. In fact, in my early days of the ministry, when I called prayer for people would start manifesting, I don't know what to start, I would just hold my hand. But there were 2 sisters in that church where I started my pastoral ministry. They've been helping me. I phoned my boss. I have never read anything about deliverance then. I've never gone to deliverance school then. I remember one American man, he came to our service. He normally started by 7 a.m. As the prayer was going on, the man opened his eyes, he folded his eyes. He was watching at this school. They have not eaten anything 7 a.m. and I prayed like this. The prayer was very heavy. As he was falling, one power just fell upon him before he went. He was, you know, the power pushed him under the bench. After the service, he said, Pastor, what happened? People have come to me, maybe one prayer is done and they manifest. So they ask me questions. Pastor, what if I say, I don't know. There is no pastor, no evangelist, no prophet that can tell you this is ABC of how many problems. Miracle is not X plus X is equal to 2X. Miracle is not X raised to power 2 plus 4X minus 8 and so on that you can solve a quadratic equation. It is not a simultaneous equation that you can solve simultaneously. It is not a Pythagoras theorem that you can prove that to. It is not like that. Praise the name of the Lord. It is not like a counting equation where you say what? It is not like a counting equation. It's not. Praise the name of the Lord. It's not like a counting equation where you say what? Well, asset plus debit equal to what? Capital. It's not. Okay. So we need to look at this. One thing I want to understand is this. The gift of the Lord is without repentance. What did I say?
The gift of the Lord is without repentance.
I do know, I've already, people already manifested my ministry before I didn't even know. I never knew. Because I was afraid. Romans chapter 11, verse 29. I shall not go to hell in Jesus' name. I shall not go to hell.
I shall not go to hell.
Romans chapter 11, verse 29. Are you done? He says, for the gifts and calling of God are without repentance. Look at it. For the gifts and what? And the calling of God are what? They are repentance. What God gives to you, you can be using it. A lot of people that are still manifesting the gift, they are no longer the will of God. They are just manifesting it. That is why miracle deceive. As you have put the end time, miracle will increase. Ironically, people are looking for miracles. That's why people are not looking for Jesus. People are not looking. I thank God for that discussion that this had with me. And after that, I dropped my phone. I started ruminating upon it just for truth. The gifts and the calling of God are not what are without repentance. People are looking for miracles and they've entered to bondage. People are looking for miracles and they've entered to captivity. People are looking for miracles and they have been unconsciously initiated. People are looking for miracles and they become Satan servants. The gifts are what? And the calling of God are what? They are all repentance. Miracle does not carry people to heaven. It is not a passport for heaven. Nobody will go to heaven because of the quality of the miracles to work. Sometimes when you see people defending ministers of God on the social media, they are beating them. You are not happy. So that they can make adjustment. Judas was part of the group that went out and cast demons. Eventually, he missed it. Praise the name of the Lord. So the gifts and the calling of God are what? They are without repentance. And let me tell you something. When the Lord Jesus Christ sent out the 70 disciples in the book of Luke chapter 70, by the time they came, they were rejoicing that they cast out demons and also said, No. Do not rejoice because of that, but simply do that what? Your names are written in heaven. And we look at the book of Luke chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. I read from verse number 10, verse number 1, see. After this thing, the Lord appointed verse 70 also too. Initially, Jesus had already sent the 12 disciples and sent them two and two before his face into every city. He set them in a group. He set them in a team and place whither he himself will come. They prospered the advanced part of the Lord Jesus Christ, not that they walk ahead. Now, and then, verse 17, and the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are sorry to talk to them. Read verse 17. And he said unto them, I bear them as lightning from heaven. Behold, I give unto you power to tell the serpent as scorpions and all the power of the enemy. And none shall bend this one to verse 20. Say, notwithstanding this, not that the spirit has spoken unto you, but rather rejoice, because of this and in heaven. Because of what? Yeah. Even when all these disciples were still casting out demons and walking miracles, you see, I doubt whether they have received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Okay? Because if you look at the full baptism of the Holy Ghost actually came in Acts chapter number 2. Uh-huh. If you look at the book of John, chapter number 20, you will see where the Lord Jesus had bread for them. Uh-huh. And by that time, they were able to recognize the rising Jesus. But the anointing, the Holy Ghost anointing, the Holy Ghost outpouring came in Acts chapter 2. I don't want to go into that right now. You can look at a message either on Facebook or YouTube. What I call, you know, Holy Spirit, my helper. Come and help me now. I put it in bracket, the paraclete and what? The advocate. I want to encourage you to listen to that message. You can follow us on YouTube. You can follow us on Facebook. You can check that message there. Other pastors are delivered. When you click it, those messages will come up. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now I said that. He said, do not rejoice. Let me tell you what he said. He said, do not rejoice at those Christ and the power that are subject to God. Rejoice that your names are written in heaven. What should give us joy is that our names are written in heaven. That should be the source of our joy. Not that kind of the people we are talking about. And he said, do not rejoice. He said, that your names are written in heaven. Cast out demons, but what? Your names are written in heaven. He said, behold, he said, notwithstanding in this, that was 20. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not. Come on. Look at come on. He said, do not enjoy the pastor. I said, you know they can say, behold, he said, and the 70 returned again with joy. He said, no, even the devils are subject unto us through their name. When you see some people broadcasting, people manifesting right now, they've been broadcasting. We are not tough that way. We are not what? When we are people will not be showing them on television, people will show them, no. Jesus, they were enthused. They were excited. They were very happy. See, they were interested. See, that kind of thing. They want to be showing off. There was a particular place in the Bible where they saw somebody casting out demons in the name of Jesus, and they forbid him. But Jesus Christ said, everybody's not against us, it's for us. It's a spirit of sectarianism. That person was not a disciple of Jesus. But then they saw him casting out demons. They said, let us stop. He said, no, don't stop that. Praise the name of God. Now, this is what you look at. He said, we saw demons, they are responding. Behold, we say, even devil, the subject of God, to your name. And we say, in the name of Jesus, they were going out. That's why I said, notwithstanding this, rejoice not. It's not a sin of boasting. Rejoice not that the Spirit has subject of you, but rather rejoice because of this and this in him. That should be the source of joy of any man of God. That should be the source of joy of any Christian. As far as the Bible is concerned. That is the introductory part of my message. So that miracles is not the answer. If you are looking for miracles, you go to the wrong place. Anything you see, carry it along. If you are looking for miracles, you enter the body and they multiply. You have multiplication of problems. It's your own part of, kettle of tea. Problems are many. There are problems, there are difficulty, but at the same time, there is solution. There is what? Solution. I am not doubting it. There are problems, there are difficulties, there are hardship, but the truth of this word, there is solution. If only you can keep to Christ, by the 5 minutes after I started praying, you can join us. The data in the name is about 200 to 300 data, which you can use to buy coal or to do other things. We've already started praying because things are not, this is an abnormal time. Something happened that I was so sad. A woman very close to us, and some members of the church will know this, because sometimes he has helped the church to cook food in programs. We are told that the woman just died. And what happened? This woman ate the dream. She ate the dream, and that was where the problem started. Something you could have seen the stomach and then punctured it, and the food will come out. The new demon of next gate will have kept out in the name of source. In those days, we will be so see those kind of say, this is a we've seen all this kind of things happening. Satan is oppressing people. But thank God you are alive. Some of the little things that if I have got knowledge in those days, we have helped mankind. But then we are moved. But we thank God for the present situation right now. So no man of God can make this happen. Nobody. It is the work of the Holy Spirit. The gifts of God are without repentance. The fruit of the Spirit are very essential. Some of the things you see on the pulpit, they are very different from what you see on the private lives. The fruit of the Spirit, they are the prerequisite for you to make progress with God. And that is why you must strive for it. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, it is As far the Bible has prophesied in the land, the miracles will happen. That if it are possible, the elect will what? Be deceived. He said it. Plenty of miracles that if it happens, the elect world will be deceived. If you look at the book of Mark chapter 13, is there, Mark chapter 24, Jesus Christ said it also too. That miracle will happen so much. Matthew chapter 13, verse 6 says, for many shall call in my name, say I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And when ye shall hear of words and words of war, be not troubled. For such things be, but the end shall not hear. For nations shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be earthquakes in diverse places, and there shall be famines and trouble. This is at the beginning of war of sorrow. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you can see many things. If you look at verse number 21, or let me go to verse 22. For false Christ and false prophets shall rise, and shall show signs and wonders. They shall show what? To seduce people. If you allow yourself to be seduced by signs and wonders, if you allow yourself to be deceived, when miracles are happening, that means I'm going there. Can you please not ask, what is the power behind that miracle? Look at Matthew chapter 13, verse 13. For false Christ and false prophets shall rise, shall show signs and wonders to seduce. If it are possible to delay. You know what?
Yes.
It is impossible, but take it, you have foretold all this. Jesus has foretold all this. Take it, take it, take it. I have foretold you all these things. Jesus Christ has foretold you. This is like the whole world is in problem right now. People are looking for solution. Jesus Christ has foretold you this. Praise the name of the Lord. Mm-hmm. I will prophesy. Cast out demon. What will you lose? What? Go to what? Say, take it. Take it. So miracles will increase in the last days. It will increase in the last days. I must tell you. If you go to the book of Revelation, you will see similar thing. It has been prophesied there. It will increase. Praise the name of the Lord. It will increase. Then as Christians, what is it with our attitude? As Christians, what should be our disposition? The Bible says in the book of 1 Peter, chapter 4, verse 17. He said, judgment shall start in the house of God. Are we there? Let's go there. 1 Peter chapter 4. Verse number 17. For the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if faith begin at us, what shall be the end of them that obey not the gospel of God? Verse 18. And if the righteous shall scarcely be saved, we have two kinds of righteousness to our God, the imputed righteousness and righteousness as an act. The imputed righteousness is the righteousness Jesus Christ imputed to us when we are born again. But we have righteousness as act. When you begin to live your life, are you living righteously? You understand the distinction right now. You understand what God said right now. Because there are people that will tell you that you cannot imputed righteousness, you cannot so and so and so forth. We have imputed righteousness, then we have righteousness as act. Once you are born again, righteousness is a gift from God already put in you. But as you live on in your journey of life, the act of righteousness, not back. Shall we say? If the righteous has started to say, where shall the ungodly and sinner appear? Okay? Now, there are people that go about with the doctrine of eternal security that is once you are born again, you are born again with an eternity. It's not the fallacy. It's an hypothesis without any, Now, with this, what should be our attitude? What should be our perspective? I go to the book of Colossians, chapter number 3. Colossians, everybody go to that place. Colossians chapter 3. The book of Colossians, are we there? Are we there? Okay. I read now, Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the hand of God. Number one, seek those things which are above. See what? That should be our perspective right now. The world may be challenging, at the same time, very exciting and rewarding. Some of our youth of that days, they don't know what it costs. For the truth they are hearing right now. If not somebody put 30 years, all people have led in 3 years. You see youths, they are falling famed fraudsters. All kinds of things by the fallen famed fraudsters. Somebody showed the number of stupid that are falling fashion for plenty. They have more than a group that are falling down for $10. Praise the name of the Lord. There are scores of people that if we have understood some of the things we have done today right now, we have helped them. But I told you, we don't have, you know, we didn't understand some of these things. Thank God for the truth that you are hearing right now. And then who much is given, much is what? Much is expected. Now I said, if you have been listening with Christ, see those things which are above. So our percentage will see those things which are above, which I'm going to explain. If I said the fact that you are listening with the Lord Jesus Christ, because the three aspects of death and resurrection are what? The seat of the Lord Jesus Christ, or the right hand of God, we are partakers. The Bible says we are seated within the heavenly places. Isn't it? Isn't it? When the Lord Jesus Christ, you are dead within in baptism. And when you come out, you are listening also with him. So we are partakers. We must seek those things which are above. If you are satisfied that you are risen with Christ, therefore, we must seek those things which are above. Now, we must make a decision on how to invest our time on this in heaven. We must take a decision on what kind of pleasure are we to pursue if we believe in this verse. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you look at it at the same time, in the existence of a particular country, you have an apply for the passport of that nation. I have a Nigerian passport. They also have a passport of heaven. And if you are a Nigerian citizen, you also have an American citizen, and you have to have three passports. The passport of America, the passport of Nigeria, what? The passport of what? Heaven. Say, I'm holding my passport of heaven.
I'm holding my passport of heaven.
If I'm holding the shoulder of the leader, you understand what I'm saying at all. Set your affection on the sense of heaven. Number two, multiply your word for members. Multiply it. It's very, very, I continue to say, multiply that for your members upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil conspicuous and conventions, and which are idolatry. For which things say the wrath of God only for children of disobedience. So, this, and when you multiply all these things, you get it out of your life. President Lord.
Yeah.
There is emphasis on what to modify. Those things, you must kill them. If your desire is money, the money has become your God. There are some people, their children have become their gods. There are certain things that if you have strong desire for them, they will keep you in bondage. They will do what? Yes. Some of the things you have strong desire for, they will keep you in bondage. Check it. Those things you have desire for, you need to modify it. I have desire for all kinds of things, they will keep you in bondage. If you have desire for one, they will keep you in bondage. They will keep what? In bondage. And that one can be very, very dangerous. Can be what? Dangerous. There are parents that make idols of their children. There are children that make idols of their parents. There are pastors and church members that make idols or ministers of God. I pity them. They make idols of general overseers. They make idols of bishops. They make idols of prophets and so on and so forth. It's only three that work miracles. I've been involved in ministry of miracles. Well, since we started this online service, I've heard of kind of healings. This has happened to my husband. I don't know how it happens. How can I pray for somebody here in a new group? The person was sacked in the job, and then within 3 days, the person was sacked. I don't know. I am going to say the curse of healing God has worked through this online service. Don't start putting my picture somewhere. Don't put my picture in your status or something. Don't put it in your status or the calling. Don't do that. Anything that comes before, it will not enter your life. Men of God, people are worshiping them right now. Let God fight for men of God. Praise the Lord. People cannot worship the creation of the creators. They worship what? They watch the creation of the you can see it there. If you attack Jesus, nobody will say anything. But attack a particular man of God, you see what kinds of people are saying. Attack Jesus. Say Jesus is back. People will not say anything. But mention a particular name of God that I do not hide out. Will this sound how people will run out? The question is, where do I have the affection? Let me go to Philippians chapter 3, verse number 17. Philippians, just move back. Philippians. Brethren, be followers together of me. Among them which walk so as if. Also, for an example, for many work of whom I've told you often, I'm not telling you weeping, that the enemies of the cross of Christ. That what? The enemies of what? The cross of Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. Number three, don't be called the enemies of the cross of Christ. You are not the enemy of Christ, but what? The enemies of the cross. The cross is the bridge to move from your salvation, from the unbelieving state to what? To the believing state. Don't be called I am stumbling block to do that. I want to do that. I want to do that. I say, if this person who comes inside Christian, I will never go to church. And the Bible says, if anyone should make anyone this stumbling, it's better than what? That a millstone should be cast upon the head and throw what is there to see. If a man has made another people to stumble, it's a little special. Enemies of the cross, not Christ. And the enemies of the cross, the man are the things. The interest is on other things. I don't know. For many one of whom I've told you often, and now tell you, even weeping, Paul was weeping when he was asked to the Philippian church, that they are enemies of us, whose end is destruction, whose one is their belly, whose glory is their shame, who might every things. Now, if you start reading from verse number 17, let me follow so that we can get a good understanding. Brethren, you follow us together for me, Thomas. And man then, which well, so I say also for an example, full stop. Continue. For many work of whom I've told you often, I'm not telling you even with me. He has been telling them often and often. He has been hearing messages often and often. Paul is now with me. Was not with me. Say, is now with me that they are the enemies of the cross. Look at whose end is that social? After he has told them several times, he's now put a kind of judgment in them. Okay? Whose blood is their belly? And whose blood is what? Their shame. Who might have it is? Who might have it? That is the concluding thing. In other words, they might what? Have it is. All the preceding things you have been saying. Okay? The summary of it was, they might what? Have it is. The level of interest in everything can determine whether you're interested in heaven. Can determine what? Whether you're interested in heaven. Where do we belong? We belong to heaven. Where do we belong? Ask me the question. We belong to heaven. Look at what has happened right now. It does not take long more than 2 seconds to wipe out the whole world. Sodom and Gomorrah, how many people are saved? During the prayer of man, how many people are saved? Mind and ethics. When you belong to the nation, you are attached to the pastor of the nation. If your God is bad, if the end is destruction. I love food, I cannot go to my stomach. Praise the name of the Lord. I read on. For our conversation is in heaven. Now, that conversation means citizenship. What does it mean? Praise the name of the Lord. The New Testament was interpreted from the Greek. Why the New Testament for what group? That conversation means citizenship. And somebody, if you want to put on the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse number 40, says, we have no continued sitting here. But we see what? We want to continue. That if you are Lagosian, we Lagosian, Lagos is not our continued city. That's what the Bible says. Can we go to the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 14? Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 14. Everybody read this. Let's go to that place. Hebrew chapter 13. Are we there?
Yeah.
And read verse 1 for, let's read together. Let's go.
But
we
seek one to
come. Second, everybody go. For here, I know the true city. For the last and last reading. For here, I know the true city. For the last and last reading. You may come from the battle. The battle is not a city of continuity. A time will come when you are passing on. The city is in heaven. That's why, let me go back to the book of Philippians. Okay, it said, for our conversation is in heaven. At least for our citizenship is what is in heaven. For whence also we look for the Savior of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ standing at the right hand of God, making intercession for me and for you also too. Who shall change our vile body, that it shall be fashioned unto his glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able to submit all things unto himself. In other words, he's going to change our body to a glorious body. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I believe it literally is going to happen. What did I say? I don't know what. He said, then we share our body will change. I believe in that, but I don't know how it's going to happen. I don't know. I don't know. He said, we did a kingdom of our eyes, look at that for instance. So if you close your eyes and you open it, believe that thing for a while, the body is already changed. How is it going to happen? I don't know. I don't know. But I believe in it. I believe what? I don't know what I want. I believe in it. Second Corinthians chapter 4. I believe in it. I don't know. It was so capable. Verse 15. I read from verse 15. Are we there? Now, for all things are your fellowships, that the abundant grace through the thanksgiving of many redound to the glory of God. Now, you see, the next is what? Tap onto the abundant grace of God so that you can make heaven. That is the next thing. Tap into the abundant grace of God to make heaven. You see, for all things are for your sakes. All things are for your sake. Whether you have sheep, jetliner, vehicles, clothes, all kinds of things, they are for your sakes. The government are for your sakes. Whether at the federal level, the state level, at national level, they are for your sakes. See, all things are for your sakes. That's why many people are trying to resource on it. Yes, I believe so. Let them resource control. But a group of men gather that they have their resources. Government are for our sakes. They are for our sakes. The Bible says, all things are for your sake. Underline it and claim it after the service. Anyone has to underline after the service, go and sit down and read it. And be very Christians. If you are a member of God's financial evangelical ministry, you should be very prayerful and at the same time, very strong in the word of God. Very strong in the word of God. Heavily, the word content in you must be very heavy. Like somebody had born with high barrier content of Koro. The word content of that must be very, very heavy. He said, all things are for sale, whether the government at national level, at the state level, they are for sale. The aeroplane, they are for sale. The jet line, they are for sale. The sun, they are for sale. Everything, they are for sale. I know that the abundant grace might be through the thanksgiving of many redeemed to the glory of God. Praise the Lord. I read verse 16. For which cause you faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. Verse 16. Outward man perish is your physical body. Your body will start the process of decay. No matter how long you take care of the body, everybody will think about this morning. Put on cream, okay? Our ear also cream it. Not only that, we put on perfume. No matter, I say this, our physical body will vanish. The process starts at our heart. You can delay, but you cannot stop it. You can do what? You can delay, you cannot stop it. The outward will vanish. You may try to wrap it up, do many kind of surgical operations, but then you can only delay it, you cannot stop it. The answer to my prayer is not as sure as you are born. Praise the name of the Lord. It starts as soon as what you are born. You see, the outward man is perished for what? The inward, you know, let me read it. For though we came not, but though our outward man perished, yet the inward man is what? New day by day. Most people do not think that we are going to die. They don't think it. We are going to die, I'm going to die. The kind of people do not come to the simple fathers. We are going to die. They don't bear to that simple fact. Praise God. Mm-hmm. Praise the name of the Lord. Mm-hmm. When I listened to some of the message of Dr. Maurice Elulu, the man served for 16-17 years. That's not to do with God right now. Some of you just asked serving God at the age of 50. Maybe not serving God for 25, they say you're serving God. Even your resources, your money, you're always having God, your money can never serve God. Who they find it God, they won't drop off it. Them to talk of that. Now, I read on. Inward man is renewed. The inward man is in direct contact with the Lord Jesus Christ. What did I say? What did I say? Your inward man is in direct contact with Jesus Christ. He's a seed of the right hand. You can live your life. We have enough resurrection life with the Lord Jesus Christ to keep us healthy. Say, I have enough resurrection life to keep me healthy. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I read on to verse 17. It says, when we look now at the things, verse 17 says, for our life ambition, which is but for a moment, walk out for us, a far more exceeding and eternal. Listen to that one. Everybody is complaining of one another, isn't it? Now, Paul says the affliction he went through was a light affliction. Corona people already complaining. Paul, he was beaten several times. Paul was in prison. All kinds of things. He suffered shipwreck, but he called it a light affliction. He called it what? What Paul went through. Can you compare what a person to? I'm quite complete right now. Shipwreck, he was beaten with us, he was stoned. He called it like affliction. But affliction was for Christians so as to shape them. Affliction will mold us. So that we can get closer to God. So that we can think about heavenly goal. Yes, I read on. For our life affliction, which is for a moment, is for a moment. Working for us in family city, an eternal way of glory. Why we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal. All the beauty you have seen are temporal, isn't it? All the time you have seen are temporal. But the things which are not seen, they are eternal. They are what? Eternal. All the things you have seen, they are eternal. We will see civilization crumble. We will see nations. You know, that rose to heaven into a high level of glory, then they came down. The things you see, they are temporal. The things you don't see what? They are eternal. Brothers and sisters, what manner of person we want to be? It is time for we to set our affection on things above and not be beneath, where Jesus Christ is waiting for us. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise Jesus. He said we need to set our precious on this above. Will you close your eyes? Ask God to forgive you. If you are holding the passport of hellfire, he will drop it to you. Talk to God. Talk to God right now. Talk to God Almighty. That Lord, every sin that can hold you down, that Lord should forgive you. Talk to God. Talk to God. Character, case, and behavior of life that can hold you down. Talk to God. Don't receive miracles and go to hell. Miracle is not a yardstick for measuring your spiritual progress.
miracles. Even people who are not of the sun, they can take the cross. Are you a miracle seeker and you are not seeking for God? Talk to God. Talk to God. Decide to make adjustments. Make up your mind. Set your affection on this above. Not athletes. The things you saw are temporal. They can vanish. The cars, the clothes, the beds, the mansions, they are vanish. So many buildings, they are becoming empty right now. Because people are now working from home. Talk to God. You need to reorganize your priority. In fact, escape desire for a particular thing can lead to bondage. The bondage you are taking yourself to, you need to pray to get yourself out of it. And for those who are looking for miracle, miracle above prophecy, above, okay, it's okay. Talk to God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Without any prayer points, and you are going to rise up, go sit down. You are going to rise up, say, oh Lord, my Father.
Oh Lord, my Father.
I say, rise up, everybody. Oh Lord, my Father.
Oh Lord, my Father.
Give me the grace to make heaven. In the name of Jesus, I want to rise up. To make that heaven. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, if my name has been removed from the book of life, then restore back now. In that name of Jesus, restore back right now. In that name of Jesus, restore back right now. Restore back. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Now sit down, you are going to pray, say, speak of what is ever coming. You need to talk to the spirit of oneness. Get out of here. Get out. Get out. Sit down and pray to yourself and then mention them one by one. The spirit of oneness. Get out. Get out of here. Get out of here now. Get out of here. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the rest of the mission. We pray for the in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please listen to this announcement. The VG, this is the last Friday, is compulsory. That VG is compulsory. And it's freedom from attacks of glory. The flyer will send it to our chat and group. You can also send it to your friends. Just as Randy said, you can watch out through devices like YouTube, Zoom, whichever one you prefer. Attack of glory is something that is very common in our environment. If you are used to carry an issue, you need those kinds of prayer, or you put decision there. Your glory is your spiritual currency to serve pastor. Your glory is what qualifies for a standard achievement. That PG, make sure you partake. I will send some prayer point by Wednesday so that you can pray it on Friday. Comes down on Friday with pastor. The prayer for the recovery of glory is not something you have to do gently. You have to pray yourself and pray your children. So it's a prayer that will be done with aggression, with serious fasting. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Bring out your hands and offer us a good prayer. Don't sit down, please. One of us, after all, give to us and give to us. Bless us and follow us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, just as I said, it's a program that requires fasting. And you're going to start at 11 p.m. But I want to tell you, for those of you that love prayer, by 20 minutes to 11, the prayer will start. Invest your treasure in praying. The more you pray, the more you discover, and you discover what? The more you recover. We need prayer this time around. The whole world is going and traveling. We need prayer. If you're closer, pray for the nations. Pray for the country. Pray for everything. The Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Then the first Sunday, we are looking at what I call the power of impact. In other words, craving your name on the sands of time. You will see it also in our prayer. Follow us on our group chats and other things. So the Lord will help us in Jesus' mighty name.
Mm-hmm.
I want to close right now, but we have this prayer to pray for us, our national evangelical ministry.
Say, every instrument of wicked against God's financial budget comes in. That's why I am so in Jesus' name, every satanic plan for God's power, may it pass right down. In the name of Jesus, may it pass, may it pass, may it pass, in Jesus' name. But I'm going to put that up in the ministry, put that up in the ministry, put that up in the ministry, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Send the links of the person that can help us. Let's have some special guests, but let's go. And this of the Lord of God, 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 the Lord of God